Well, I won the die roll again, which is a good start. And I don't think I mull this hand. It's about as mediocre as it gets for me to keep it, though. I mean, I can't even cast Edric turn three, but Blipper Elf is a very powerful card. And if I draw a two drop Accelerant, oh man, it is on. Play Treetop. The best card in my deck right now is Explore. So I can draw Explore into, like, I don't even care, anything. Blue Source would be okay. Trading Rider's not great. The plus side, I might get to attack with Treetop Village next turn. I'm not sure what my opponent's going to do about those kind of beatdowns. I'm not attacking into a swamp, though. No way. Ooh, Green Sun Zenith. What can I get for two that is sweet? I mean, I could get like a Sylvan Caryatid or something, but I actually think I'm just going to pass here. Seems like getting just a mana accelerant doesn't matter because Bloodbraid is going to hit mana so much of the time here. Flicker Wisp, sure. Flicker Wisp it up. Alright, there's an alternate Bailoff. Let's just play Bloodbraid. The fact that Bloodbraid hits a good accelerant, come on. Ooh, Pokrasite? There we go. It's kind of the combo. And yeah, sure, I'll trade a Bloodbraid for your Flicker Wisp. I imagine that's gonna happen, given that I have a 4/4 in play ready to go. The combo. I mean, I hit what the one card besides Cord. Cord would be the worst card, but I hit Apocrisite, whereas hitting like Nature's Lore or something would have been kind of cool, because then I could cast my spells. But if I don't draw blue in the next two turns, then whatever. I mean, I'll probably cast Obstinate Baleth next turn, and then turn after that. Likely, maybe Green Sunzing for like a Deranged Hermit if I draw another green source. Skin Render, killing the Bloodbraid Elf. Okay, I can live with that, I suppose. I can play Edric, but I think I'd rather just play Obstinate Baleth here. This looks like a racing kind of game here. Could also play Trading Rider, but we are interested in the beatdowns. Play Obstinate Baleth, then play a Steam Vents and pass the turn. Next turn, I can play Edric, animate Treetop, and attack for 11 damage and 3 cards, which is pretty good. My opponent's in the finals with a Flicker Wisp Skin Render deck, so it's kind of an accomplishment. The Underground Sea makes my opponent's deck look way better. I mean, black-white mid-range is not really what I think of when I think of great cube decks, but if my opponent's just like an Esper control deck with some random creatures in it, maybe that works too. Who knows? I guess I'm not sure exactly what's going on over there quite yet. Gideon Jura. Well, I know I'm in trouble. Gideon Jura is very annoying. Well, what do you do here? If you plus it and then attack with both, you've got to block at least one. All right. Let's see. So that negates my plans of Edricking. I could attack with Treetop, but I would rather play Trading Rider this turn, so let's just attack Gideon with both. And if I get double blocked on my Bailoff, and then Gideon goes to four, I can live with that. Interesting, the double chump. That makes me think my opponent's gonna Wrath. Makes me very suspicious. Don't really want to get my Trading Rider Wrath, but I also don't know what I can do about it. I mean, I guess I cannot play anything, and I can Green Suns. I mean, I can't get anything too insane with Green Sun Zenith right now. Green Suns for Mystic Snake, except it doesn't quite work. I could play a Wall of Roots. Yeah, I guess Wall of Roots is a decent hedge. If my opponent has Wrath, then that's fine. If my opponent doesn't have Wrath, at least Wall lets me go for something a little bigger here. The double chump. Well, I mean, my opponent may have gotten me here. We'll see. Nope, there goes the Wrath. Alright, well, Apocrisite's on suspend. And I still have things I can play. Getting into Wrath is powerful. Looks like my opponent's got a nice little control deck here. I like getting attacked instead of getting plussing, though, since this is a little easier to deal with. Primal Commander would be a nice draw. See if I can hit one of those. Island. Well, let's play some things, hey, shall we? And I think I'm going to play Edric. And then I guess, I mean, I'm saving the Primal, or the Green Sun Zenith rather, for Avenger of Zendikar. Soren's Thirst. Ugh. Had no good target so far, but Edric certainly gave my opponent one. But I mean, this could also get a deranged hermit if I really need to. I guess given that I have a trading rider out, if my opponent doesn't kill a trading rider, I might need to get a creature. So I might need to green zones there. Blood Baron of Vizcopa. Okay, that's like mildly annoying. Courser, well, that actually counts as a creature. And I could draw lands off the top. Come on, Courser. Primal Command's actually good, so just pass. If my opponent attacks me with Blood Baron, I'd probably just take it. Go to five here. So I'm not worried about getting burned out or anything. I basically don't want to tap Trading Rider unless I'm bouncing Gideon, so I don't want to like bounce Blood Baron mid-combat, because then my opponent can minus Gideon and kill Trading Rider, and I do not want that to happen. So let's just take it. I'm not scared. My opponent plus is Gideon. It's kind of annoying, but I guess the fact that I'm going to bounce it makes it kind of irrelevant. Ooh, no instant speed removal. Nice. Actually, I'm going to Primal Command that. So let's bounce this. Since I don't need to search for any good creatures here, could also just try to kill Gideon. Because I have enough. Court of Calling, that's interesting too. So I have 6, 9, 10. But then I animate Treetop, and if that doesn't work, all right, let's just... But I want to shuffle my opponent's Wrath back. This is actually really weird. What do I do here? Because if my opponent had a removal spell, surely they would have killed the Trading Rider, right? In response to me activating Treetop Village? The next one I get to draw a Cord. I'm going to go for it. This is potentially horrendously greedy, but... Let's see if this works. I'm going to look so stupid if this doesn't work. Don't tap mana. Don't do anything. This actually... There's no way this is the right play. If my opponent has something, I'm going to have to, like, emergency green suns for a chump blocker for Gideon. What am I doing here, exactly? I mean, granted, if my opponent had a removal spell, I can't imagine not casting it, but maybe they have a flash creature? Makeshift Mannequin targeting Skindred? Oh my god, that's the worst thing I can ever imagine. Okay, well, we learned an important lesson about being horrendous here. So now we kill the treetop, and I guess... just bounce, and then I have to green sun zenith. I'll just go for three since I don't even know what I can get here. And I think it's just all like two drops. And I got negated, and now I'm going to die. Wow, that is impressive. That is impressive. Alright, so let's see. What happens if I just... Actually, never mind. I mean, yes, that play was bad, but if I Primal Commanded, my opponent would just negate it. And then attack me with Gideon, because I would have to attack, so... I think I'd actually end up in the same place. That doesn't make the play less bad, but I would have lost it either way. That is worth noting. All right, Beast Within's coming in. What's going out? Treachery doesn't seem great now. He takes Blood Baron. That seems actually kind of good against the black-white deck. Obstinate Bailout's got to be decent, right? My opponent's got to have ways to discard. This feels like it's got to be an okay matchup, except for Wrath. Wrath is a beating. Negate's also kind of nice. Didn't see anything to Ancient Grudge or Nature's Claim. What do I want to cut here? I like most of the other cards. This deck is all good cards. How can I cut anything? I don't want to cut a 2-drop Accelerant. Apoxites does seem pretty sweet. Kitchen Finks, I guess, matches up poorly against some of those things, but it's good against Wrath. And maybe we'll just take out the Baeloth here.